fruit.
Please be seated. Please be seated. Good evening. I would like to welcome you all this evening to Abilene East High School's Class of 2019 graduation ceremony. My name is Matt Mino, principal here at Appleton East. I'm so honored and excited to MC this celebration. This ceremony caps 13 years of successful education by these students and is an important milestone in their lives. On behalf of the class of 2019 and all the staff and students at Appleton East High School, thank you to the entire East community for your support of these wonderful students. It is appreciated more than you will ever know. I would like to recognize Aiden Olmsted and Emily Van Hammond for the presentation of colors, and Grant Cook and Samuel West for their work tonight as marshals. A special thanks goes to the Appleton East Orchestra under the direction of Miss Anna Levitt for their processional music of Pomp and Circumstance. At this time, I am proud to present our Student Council Executive Board, Anna Murphy-Pochesk, Olivia Reichart, and Lauren Peterson, who will lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance. Please stand.
Good
Good evening. Please join us in the reciting of the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
As part of our graduation ceremony this evening, I am honored to recognize a staff member who will be retiring. Virginia Sturdivant in Family Consumer Education has contributed greatly to our district and to Appleton East High School for many years and in many different ways. Virginia, you will be missed. I would like to personally thank her and offer this opportunity for all of us here this evening to show our appreciation for her hard work and dedication on behalf of the students of the Appleton East community. Thank you. I would now like to introduce the Appleton East Choirs featuring the class of 2019 under the direction of Mr. Dan Van Sickle. They will be performing Bridge Over Troubled Water by Paul Simon and Kirby Shaw. At this time, please welcome our first class speaker, Ms. Erin Gretzinger, to the podium.
It starts with your heartbeat. When showtime finally arrives and the stage manager calls places, the music fades into the background and the whispers of the audience wither. Soon, all you can feel is your heartbeat. With palms sweating, gut churning, knees shaking, and bladder bursting, the house lights go down and the red curtain comes up. Time slows, and it is your moment to step on stage into that spotlight. Well, here we are, in our final moments before we take our place on this stage. And I don't know about all of you, but I'm terrified. Although maybe not as terrified as when I first started high school, or as terrified as I am giving this speech. But this is no time for stage fright. And I guess that what I'm trying to say is that, in a way, high school is a lot like theater. Can you remember what it was like 4 years ago? Didn't that first day of freshman year feel like one long audition? It was a pretty classic scene. We walked endlessly around the circle, got lost in colored staircases, received overly excited looks from upperclassmen in neon shirts, and cried when our locker wouldn't open. Well, maybe that last one was just me, but regardless of stumbles, we made the cast, and then commenced 4 years of a show we will never forget. On the stage that was Appleton East, we worked with each other and reached within ourselves, developing our character through different roles. We played shy freshmen, lost in the jungle of scary upperclassmen. We performed as snarky sophomores, daring to steal parking spots from seniors and wearing our resulting parking tickets with pride. We were then cast into the role of stressed juniors, cramming for our hardest classes in the ACT while trying to beef up our college apps. This year, we shined as seniors. In each of these roles, we built our characters through challenges we never predicted. Whether it was adjusting to the locking of the John Street doors or trying to comprehend new grading for learning standards. More seriously, we overcame academic strife, personal struggles, and great losses. So maybe we flubbed a few lines or missed an entrance along the way. And when a few performances were canceled, we just added 10 minutes to the beginning and end of each show and it all turned out totally fine. Regardless, the show went on and our characters just grew stronger. We also had moments of glory, company bows, and cheers from the crowd. Like when Matt Moore had placed top 20 in the nation at the debate tournament of champions. Or when Sam Bruton helped break the school record in the 4x200 meter relay. And girls soccer won its first ever conference title. We've made some pretty miraculous achievements, but more than all of these, we won the Powder Puff game. Yeah. This really has been a great show. Although we didn't always get the part we wanted or thought we deserved. We didn't always get to be in the spotlight. There have been times for all of us where we felt like the background dancers in the grand scheme of life and East. But remember this, there are no small parts. On this stage and any other, there's always going to be someone in the audience looking through all the glitz and glimmer of showbiz directly at you, applauding and cheering, watching you grow. We all matter here. So thank your fellow actors and actresses who've been learning alongside you. Thank your directors whose stage was the classroom. It was them who pushed us to be better, no matter how painful it may have been at times. From Mr. Miller's aw yas, to Mrs. Marx's circle time, to Mr. Pritzel's Reader's Digest jokes, to Miss Lawrence's cookies talk. Their lessons, both serious and silly, will stick with us forever. They have guided us into the roles we are in today and prepared us for the grander roles we will pursue tomorrow. Then, of course, there are the people behind the scenes. Whether or not we could always see them, they were there. And they are here again today, supporting us through our final bow. Our friends and family are the ones who should really be in the spotlight today, because without them, there wouldn't be a show at all. So, here we are again, with palms sweating, gut churning, knees shaking, bladder bursting, perhaps a little extra sweaty this time. And now, our final show at East is about to come to a close. I'm sure that each one of us, in some way, is terrified. It is scary to step off this stage onto a bigger set with new characters and challenges. It is scary to leave behind the lines we've memorized and the hallways and people we've come to know and love. But everything we have ever done in our lives, all the rehearsing, all the practicing, has been leading up to this moment. And we are ready. Whatever plot twists arise in our future, it is here at East where we have developed the character to face them. And I hope we all get to dance through the stages of life with a smile on our faces and a song in our hearts. So, class of 2019, Places. It is your moment. Step on this stage and take a bow. After all, the show must go on. Thank you.
Thank you, Aaron. Please welcome our next class speaker, Mr. Peter Seek, to the podium.
Good evening. Even now, standing here before all of you, it's difficult to fully realize that we've done it. After 4 years of coming here, often before the sun is even up, we're graduating. We've completed this phase of our education, both for academics and for life. Now, after 4 years here, each of us has made a connection of some sort to this school, or I hope, at least. There's so many different interests one can pursue here, and so many ways one can tailor their high school experience. When I walk out tonight, I leave behind some of the best experiences of my life. I leave behind the auditorium, where I've had so many amazing concerts. I leave the classrooms in which I've learned so much. And I leave the commons in which I've shared so many meals with so many friends. I leave behind a life I created for myself, and I go out into a great unknown, far away from here. See, our time here is kind of like a roller coaster. And yes, I know it's cliche, but bear with me. We stood in line for a while, watching those in front of us get on the ride and disembark later as changed people. Having been patient, we finally get to the ride, which begins the turmoil. We have our ups and downs, our twists and turns, our thrills and our moments of calm, but finally, the ride is approaching an end. So once the ride's over, we get off, maybe shaking a bit, still on an adrenaline rush. We finally did it. After waiting in line for what felt like eternity, after getting through loops and twists and whatnot, we're here. You may be a bit dizzy or thirsty, so get some water, some funnel cake maybe, and relax for a bit. You've earned it. With that taken care of, however, you now have the entire amusement park ahead of you. Yes, you'll have to wait in line, and yes, you might be sick from time to time, but the alternative is just going home, and you drove all this way, so take a break if you need, but it's time to go on to the next ride. This fall, I'll be attending the University of Pittsburgh, which is nearly 700 miles away. I don't know a single person that lives there, and I don't have anybody I know going there with me. So I will be completely alone, far from my friends, my family, and everything I've come to know and love in the Fox Cities. Yet in this solitude, I do not feel loneliness. Rather, I feel solidarity with all of you. Now, I don't presume to know the intricate details of what's brought any of you here. I don't know where everybody will be going as they leave tonight, but I do know that we will all stand together as young adults taking their steps out into the wider world to find a purpose and to find a life to etch out. I still remember my first day here. I was faced with a sea of strangers and countless opportunities to branch out. And so I made a decision before school even began that year to join theater, to just throw myself in and fully commit. I have made many similar decisions over the past 4 years, and even for those interests that have fallen by the wayside, never have I once regretted it. So when you find yourself alone and unfamiliar, as many of us will, throw yourself out into the world around you. Find an interest and commit to it for its full duration, and you may be surprised at just how many connections you'll make along the way. Now, I will admit, it can be scary. Some of you may have no plan for your departure, and that's okay. We don't need to have all the answers now. It is simply up to us to find them. So to those of you who don't know yet, I wish you luck, and I believe wholeheartedly that you'll find what you need. To those of you who have found a path that echoes that of your loved ones or friends, I congratulate you. If you're going into a job that runs in the family, or a college that your friends will attend alongside you, then you have little to fear. With your lives ahead of you and support behind you, it is now on your shoulders to grow into the person you want to be. And I believe that all of you will succeed. And to those of you like me, heading out into the unknown, well, I don't claim to be qualified to give you advice. This is, after all, my first time graduating high school. As such, the journey ahead sometimes scares me, as it may scare you. I haven't made a life change even remotely close to this for nearly a decade, so I personally don't have any life experience to share with you. But that said, this isn't my first ride. So we're currently hurtling down that final stretch of the track. The ride will soon be over, so enjoy what remains of it, but do not let that prevent you from looking forward to the next coaster you may ride. It may be difficult or nauseating, but embrace that and challenge it. Take pride in your future achievements and take a lesson from your failures. Tonight, East loses some of the most amazing people I've ever known, but in return, the wider world gains them. So, be excellent, be true to yourselves, and know that you are not alone. Together and apart, let's enjoy the life that awaits us beyond these halls. To those of you who have made music with me over the years, thank you. To those of you who have stood or spoken alongside me or against me, on a stage, in a classroom, or in the Capitol, thank you. To those of you who have sat alongside me to learn about the inner workings of life, humanity, and the universe, thank you. To any teachers who have had me in their class, you're welcome. And to all who have walked these halls, thank you.
Thank you, Peter. Please welcome our final class speaker of the evening, Miss Victoria Campbell, to the podium.
Good evening, everyone. I would like to take this moment to thank the Appleton East staff for giving me the opportunity to speak tonight. I would also like to thank all of my teachers that have shaped me into the individual that I am today. And lastly, I would like to thank all of my friends and my family for supporting me throughout my journey in high school. As many of you know, this marks my second year at East. And this gives me a unique perspective on what it means to be a patriot. Because this is the only high school you have known, you probably don't recognize how special East truly is. Whether we're together for a game, a pep rally, or a dance, East Charismatic Student Body bonds everyone together. We as a school community foster an inviting atmosphere that makes any stranger feel welcomed. And in the short time that I've been here, I've made many great friends who have embraced me and made me feel like I belong at East. I've made many great friends who have embraced me and made me feel like I belong at East. And coming here was much easier than the last time I had to pack up and move. I was actually born in Nashville, Tennessee, and I lived there for 9 years before moving to a much smaller town called Warrensburg, Missouri. At the time, I was in third grade, and it wasn't exactly easy to make friends because I wasn't as outgoing as I am now. For a while, I felt out of place because I didn't have my own friend group to eat lunch with or play with at recess. But one day, I met Shirley Tran. While on the swing set, she came up to me and introduced herself. She asked if I wanted to be friends with her, and thus began one of my greatest friendships. Shirley was such a vibrant, humble person. She would always reach out to me to make sure I felt included at my new school. I remember one day I was at my locker getting my stuff together to go home, and she approached me with a group of her friends. At first I was worried because I thought I was getting confronted. Then one by one, she introduced them to me and told them how I was new to school. And in that moment, I felt relief. The fact that she went out of her way to make sure that I met people and established a friendship with them left a lasting impression on me that I carried to East. Upon my arrival at East, I encountered many people who embodied the characteristics of Shirley. I first met the office staff. They greeted me with such kindness and welcomed me with open arms. And this instantly made me feel like I was always a part of East. While I was conversing with them about how nervous yet excited I was to be here, I met a spunky, lively girl by the name of Tegan Whitman. She showed me to the gym to meet the volleyball team. And as soon as I entered the gym, the entire team stood up immediately and greeted me. We formed a circle in which we shared our names and a fun fact about ourselves. And once my turn came, I shared how I love to dance. And they said, "Oh my gosh, wait until you meet Anna Murphy Pochask." And from that moment, I knew I would fit in. This is one of many examples of how the East community has embraced me. And it's a moment that was repeated by Link Crew and in choir, as well as my other classes. When I came to East, I was the new kid. But the next year, we will all be the new kids wherever we go. It is important to remember to reach out to new friends, because you never know what someone might be going through or how much they might need a friend. One of the hardest days of my life was March 14th, 2016. Early that morning, my brother woke me up with the sad news that my dear friend Shirley had died in a car accident. It was a shock. I was confused, and I didn't want to believe it was true. Even now, years later, she still has a profound impact on my life. We too have lost one of our classmates this year, Mackenzie Lehman. And although I was not especially close with Mackenzie, I sympathize with the many of you who were. I know what it is like to lose someone special. And in the years since the passing of my friend, I have learned something that I would like to share with those of you who are still grieving. The loss that you are feeling will never go away. But let me tell you, it will get better. I used to feel like Shirley's death was a gray cloud that would hang over me wherever I went. But eventually, my memory of her ceased to be an absence and became a presence. Rather than being something missing from my life, her memory became something special that I carry with me wherever I go. And it was a great awakening to me to cherish every moment. As Mackenzie once profoundly said, "Someday you will look back and know exactly why this had to happen to you. And it may not feel like it now, but soon, all of your memories of her will be happy ones. We will experience losses in our lives. We will lose people, we will lose places, and we will lose opportunities. But from these losses, we will grow. As we graduate tonight, we are losing this wonderful place we call home. And Appleton East will always be a part of us that we will carry well into the future. And when we think about high school, we will remember the happy times with a smile. We will remember all the tears, sweat, and endless nights we spent working to get where we are at this very moment. So, enjoy tonight, because this is the last time that we will be together as a class, the class of 2019. Hug those you may not see for a while. Thank those who encouraged you when you believed you couldn't. Tell someone how much they mean to you. You all have meant a great deal to me. Thank you for making me feel so welcomed. And I'm so glad that my journey brought me here to this special place. And I, for one, will never forget any of you. Thank you.
Thank you to Aaron, Peter, and Victoria for capturing the spirit of the class of 2019. Outstanding job, everybody. And now let us please welcome back the Easterners as they perform Fix You by Coldplay.
Thank you.
One more round of applause for the Easterners and the Appleton East Choir. Sometimes, when I'm going somewhere, I wait. And then somewhere comes to me. This simplistic but brilliant quote comes from a silly old bear known as Winnie the Pooh. Each year I select one movie's message that resonates with graduation, and this year's film is Christopher Robin. This movie is a sequel to the story of Winnie the Pooh. The film starts with Christopher Robin leaving the Hundred Acre Woods with all his friends, Winnie the Pooh, Owl, Rabbit, Piglet, Eeyore, and of course, Tigger, to take on a new world of adulthood. Just a quick recap on the Hundred Acre Woods for those of you who are a few years removed from the stories. It's an imaginary land where Christopher Robin learned that whether stuck in a tight jam or battling heffalumps and woozles, friends were always coming to the rescue. Now back to the movie. Before leaving the woods, Christopher Robin tells Pooh, "People are always asking, what are you going to do now? And I say, nothing, and just go ahead and do it." Pooh interjects and stating, "Doing nothing often leads the very best something." After leaving the Hundred Acre Woods, the film fast forwards through Christopher Robin's adulthood, showing moments as he attends boarding school, fights as a soldier in World War II, falls in love, has a daughter, and becomes a manager of a company. As a manager, Christopher is taxed with long hours, threats of staffing cuts, and pressures of maintaining a healthy bottom line. Christopher's work clouds the most important moments in his life and the individuals that he loves. At one point in the film, Christopher's wife states, "I haven't seen you laugh in years. Your life is happening right now, right in front of you." Shortly after this conversation, Pooh returns to Christopher's adult life and attempts to rekindle Christopher's spirit. Christopher thinks he himself has gone mad. Pooh encourages him to reclaim and embrace his inner self and the ones he loves. His message and care resurrects and provides clarity back to Christopher Robin's life. "Okay, Mr. Mino, I think you have now gone too far. Imaginary bears and animals trying to share the meaning of life. But hold on a second. How often do we take the time to pause and reflect where we are at, who we are, and where we are going? How often do we take the time to truly live in this moment?" This makes me return to Pooh's quote, "Sometimes when I'm going somewhere, I wait, and then somewhere comes to me." This quote can be hard to imagine when our lives move as fast as they do. Pooh is asking us to slow down and recognize the world around us, both good and bad. Too often, our world moves at an exponential rate, sometimes creating the feeling that there is no time to live in this moment. When we slow down, we have a chance to recognize and celebrate the events or individuals that are really important to us. The most amazing thing, though, is that we all have control of this. We can choose to pause, breathe, and catch ourselves before speeding off to the next best thing. I need some audience participation here for just 1 minute. Just take a moment and take a breath right now. Recognize the moment you're in. Take this time to recognize before you speed off to what you believe is the next best thing or more important thing. Recognize you're somewhere and acknowledge that it's right here, right in front of your face. So the next time you hear the question, what are you doing next year? Which I'm sure many of you have heard or been asked quite a few times this year. And for many of you, this question becomes daunting, to say the least. Remember that this is the same question that Christopher Robin was hearing before leaving the 100-acre woods. The unknown can sometimes feel terrifying, especially when we've gotten comfortable being in one place for a while. But remember what Christopher Robin says in the film. My response is nothing, and just go ahead and do it. Doing nothing often leads to the very best something. This nothing isn't truly doing nothing. It's again taking time to recognize the world and the most important moments around you while making the most of them. Find your moments and live them. By living the moment, you will see more clearly the individuals who are there for you and who have been there for you. Christopher Robin forgot and was clouded by the world around him. Make the choice to take a breath when things get too cloudy in your lives. Look around you this evening in the bleachers of this gym. Tiggers, Piglets, Eeyores, and Poohs are here. Today, you have an audience from the 100-acre woods of family members, friends, and teachers who are here to celebrate your endeavors while at the same time sharing in the happiness of your success. These individuals have been there for you, whether you were stuck in a tight jam or battling heffalumps and woozles. They are always coming to the rescue. Slow down and cherish their love. Tonight, you're about to venture off beyond the 100-acre wood. Class of 2019, embrace you. Embrace your somewhere. Make your somewhere about committing yourself to living in the moment that is presented to you. My hope is that East High School has given you resilience, compassion, and perseverance to keep moving forward, and that these gained learnings will assist you with whatever moments you will face today, tomorrow, or 10 years from now. In the final scene of the movie, Pooh asks Christopher Robin, what day is it? Christopher responds, it's today. Pooh answers, my favorite day. Today is my favorite day. Enjoy the day, the moment, and remember to take time to wait for somewhere, and it will come to you. Congratulations, class of 2019. At this time, I would ask our superintendent for the Appleton Area School District, Dr. Judy Baseman, to come forward so that I may present the class for graduation. Dr. Baseman, I have reviewed the records of this class and certify that the students before you this evening have met the attendance and credit requirements of this school district. As principal of Appleton East High School, I proudly present the class of 2019 to receive their diplomas.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome. It's great to be with you here this evening for this wonderful celebration. Thank you to all the families, relatives, and friends who are here with us to honor our graduates and their accomplishments. We are grateful for your partnership with us through the years. Strong partnerships with families are essential for student success. We all know this, and we need to recognize the importance of that. It's truly an honor for me to be with you here tonight, and I hope you can all feel the positive energy and joy that's in the air. Tonight is the pinnacle of a lot of hard work over the last 13 years, and it's important to enjoy this moment in time as an East High School community together. Seniors, I am so proud of you. As a class, you have been leaders in making a positive impact on this school and on this community. You are hardworking, thoughtful, and care about the people around you. I can say this because I have seen and heard that kindness in your actions and in your words. Here at East, I've seen it in so many ways. In the classrooms, in the hallways, on the athletic fields, on the theater and concert stages. You have been awesome in welcoming all those who enter East's doors. And I think Victoria shared an awesome story of how you all welcomed her, and I know that to be true for so many people who have come and been part of this community. You have helped students feel like they are a family through your kindness. And when you are faced with obstacles and unexpected tragedy, you use your sources of strength along with that kindness to help yourselves and others through those difficult times. I'm proud of your involvement as well. As a senior class, you took part in many opportunities that have been provided to you through the years, whether that be clubs or sports, multiple community service projects, or other activities. And this involvement has not only furthered your interests and skills, but has provided you with the ability to work as a team, to collaborate with one another, and to make meaningful connections and friendships with others. I hope these memories and friendships will last a lifetime for you. I am continually impressed and heartened by you, our students. You are our future, and for that, I am hopeful and optimistic. As you go out into the world, know that the knowledge and skills are important. They will get you where you want to go, but more important, and I think we all know this, will be the people that you meet along the way, the relationships you build, and the lives that you will touch. If you stay true to yourself and to your values, you will make a positive difference in our world. So whatever you choose to do next, whether that be college, career, military service, please continue to do it as good, kind, caring people. I encourage you to continue to work hard, to challenge yourselves, but be sure to do it with kindness and with compassion, just as you have here at East. Congratulations. I am so proud of you. Thank you. And now I'd like to have you help me welcome Mr. Barry O'Connor. Barry O'Connor is a member of the Appleton Area School District's Board of Education. It is truly an honor to have him with us here this evening, and I know he shares the pride we all feel as we gather at this time of celebration. Please help me welcome Mr. Barry O'Connor.
Hi, I'm thrilled to accept you as an Appleton Area School District graduate tonight. 11 years ago, you were graduating from many first grade classrooms, some in this district, some in other districts, led by many wonderful teachers. I happen to know three of those teachers really well, and I think some of you do too. Mrs. Keel, Mrs. Crom, and Mrs. O'Connor over at Johnston Elementary School. I even got to read Polar Express one time and give you a little magic bell in your class when you were first graders. And I also got to attend your picnic at the end of the year which was named Camp Learned a Lot. Good name, huh? You guys were really cute back then. And by the way, those of you who back then kept asking if I was Mrs. O'Connor's father, I have forgiven you. I'm her husband. Just want to clear that up. I have no doubt that many of you have similar experiences in your first grade careers. Those of you who are students may not remember, but at the end of the year, she wrote of her hopes for you and shared them with you and your parents. Let me share them with you again. She wrote back then, "I have often thought the world would be a better place if we all acted like first graders. We'd be excited about everything, especially learning new things. We would find new friends and simply ask, 'Do you want to play with me?' We would quickly forget about someone who was not very nice the day before and giggle with them during free time. We would celebrate the differences in our classmates with sincere hearts. We would pick up other people's messes just because it's nice to be helpful. We would hug each other during story time. We would paint with no fear of judgment and sing with loud voices. We would love to run and climb and chase. We would know it's not nice to call people names or make them feel bad. We would think it is so cool that someone speaks another language. We would be enthusiastically raising our hands to be helpers for those who need special attention. We would be kind to each other and really mean it." Now, I happen to think these qualities describe this class, this staff, and this East community quite well, especially the part about being helpful and kind when needed, being sources of strength like those family members cheering you on tonight. Here you have a school that strives to create robust programs led by great teachers that awaken in each unique you that desire to learn and to contribute to a better world. As an outside admirer, I so appreciate that all of you have helped create a strong, caring, inclusive community here. I'm not saying that it's perfect by any means, but when I see your incredible choirs full of kids, each with their own stories, each from strong cultures, presenting messages that touch our hearts and our souls to help us understand our world better, I am reassured. In a way, your class has become role models for our larger community. There is nothing more urgent in our community and our world than to blend the many wonderful cultures and individuals we have here now into the fabric of a vibrant, supportive community. So please bring that forward into your lives of the future. Continue, if you will, to act like first graders. So, on behalf of the Board of Education of the Appleton Area School District, it is my pleasure to commend each of you for your achievement and to publicly and formally accept the Appleton East High School class of 2019 for graduation. Congratulations.
Mackenzie Lehman. Accepting on behalf of Kenzie is her mother, Alyssa Peters. Anna Murphy Pochaz. Olivia Reichart. Lauren Peterson.
Stop and hold up your diploma.
Aaron Gretzinger.
Stop and hold up your diploma.
Peter Seek. Victoria Campbell. Trevor Anderson. Max Britton. Sawyer Kostelik. Jordan Fisher. Josh Hilker. Max Heinrichs. Michaela Josefchek. Jed Leisner. Mark Lorenz. Brandon Lytle. Billy Matovich. Isaac Meyer. Matthew Moorhead. Cassidy O'Kane. Sophia Osorio. Lillian Pimentel. Kayla Scaletti. Lisa Tao. Tyrus Zhang. Harry Bray. Megan Borowski. Brandon Clemente. Owen Driscoll. Juliana Duverney. Rachel Fulser. Kayla Hain. Aaliyah Hall. Katrina Hermans. Alexis Hewley. Eddie Howard. Eric Hiddle. Rachel Jackson. Isaac Jones. Colin Kochanek. Lillian Lebrec. Jacob Lawrence. Trey Nicholson. Yeah. Angelica Rios. Zach Schneider. Gabe Schaefer. Jessica Smith. Audrey Stevens. Ashley Sturm. Lena Thor. Ashley Vaughn. Anna Vicker. Evelyn Zhang. Austin Becker. Rachel Bovat. Caden Endress. Ashley Evans. Lauren Gilmeister. Gibson Hiles. Yvonne Hernandez. Madeline Jenks. Kyle Cole. Morgan Laux. Nicole Nicodem. Melanie Steffes. Jackson Mangold. Maria Minky. Jonathan Nizia.
Giselle Rios. Maria Cerna. Andrew Sweetella. Brianna Tao. Rio Tao. Taylor Yuki. Johnny V. Chase Whitman. Kiana Zhang. Kaylin Zakowski. Kyler Adams. Malia Banks. Paige Burke. Denisha Claybrooks. Carter Golden. Andrew Gosner. Chloe Hitter. Kristen Happy. Mason Kelter. Lucas Katarek. Angela Lee. Zach Leitzinger. Billy Lucht. Alexander Martinez. Sydney Olmstead. Brandon Pack. Jada Piper. Emma Pitch. Samuel Schaefer. Boston Seals. Eric Sikirki. Xavier Tomer. Kira Vandenberg. Bryson Ward. Laura Whitwer. Kong Meng Zhang. Chu Shi Vang. Kelly Burgell.
Madeline Burnside. Dylan Deeg. Maisie Foth. Damian Herr. Parker Johnson. Gavin Kraus. Nathan Lemons. Jonah Lerman. Jennifer Martinez. Samuel Marzel. Amanda Miller. Beyonce Mua. Gage Olson. Kira Peterson. Thomas Scheiber. Jenna Simo. Yur Tao. Teresa Vang. Ashley Wesley. Mai Yur Yang. Ashley Zastro. Alex Aguilar. Angela Bynes. Callie Borison. Andrea Chavez. Colin Destry.
Thank you.
Traven Feldman. Mason Getzfried. Kendra Guyette. Georgia Hoyer. Abby King. Christina Lindell. Megara Martinez. Marion McKinney. Allison Nelson. Ian O'Tone. Tristan Pettit. Lucayla Poehler. Matthew Robb. Ryan Schmidt. Bailey Schomer. Sean Stedman. Elena Stewart. McKinley Stewart. Gabriel Vandenhoevel. Olivia Van Hammond.
Thank you very much.
Savannah White.
Leah Sorensen. Kylie Bourne. Emily Breister. Caden Clark. Josh Dahl. Jordan Dietz.
Joe Edmondson. Teresa Lucille Gagno. Nikki Groff. Jack Habeck. Haley Hutter. James Kinney. Cameron Kulik. Tyler Locke. Salia Mua. Cameron Neubauer. Tiffany Paulman. Forget. Mason Rankin. Sydney Reisner. Olivia Schneider. Alyssa Strakota. Angel Turan. Tiana Van Hout. Ariel Yang. Linda Yang. Jasmine Badola. Mel Chavira. Carson Cook. Diana Enriquez. Daphne Garcia. Alec Goland. Nicholas Harrison. Melissa Herrera. Molly Hill. Asia Jorgensen. Cade Koshnick. Lupita Leon Martinez. James Maloney. Teresa Martinez. Dylan Moe. Mitchell Nowak. Thomas Olson. Chris Piccolo. Brandon Selveson Krepline. Fernando Sandoval. Komang Tao. Shandi Tao. Olivia Tyson. Jamie Van Roy. Jacob Wakuda. Jacob Wheelock. Mi Zhang. Thomas Yang. Sullivan Burns. Jen Coates. Grady Diamond. Jackson Edelbeck. Luis Enriquez. Samantha Hanneman. Kyle Hyman. Nicholas Jacobson. Matthew Lauer. Nathan Lee. Neri Lopez. Madison Lord. Jaden Lutz.
Madison Meyer. Ashlyn Mace. Alicia Nickham. Alyssa Nielsen. Andrea Ortiz-Villanueva. Benjamin Paulson. Jennifer Perlomo. Brandon Pettit. Seth Rogers. Naomi Tao. Jack Vu. Jochen Vu. Amy John.
Papa!
Elijah.
Guadalupe. Hayden Holtz. Spencer Hornum. Jonathan Joseph.
Monica Leonard.
Let's hear it for the Grand Masters. This is the moment. Class of 2019, please stand. To symbolize that you are official graduates of Appleton East High School, please turn your tassels from right to left. I am now proud to present to you the Appleton East High School Class of 2019. Congratulations.
You guys can go. Go.